Hello everyone, Alexander Flores here, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can upload files to an S3 bucket using AWS Lambda and node.js. So I have an empty folder here. I'm navigated to that folder in my console, and we're going to go ahead and run npm init-y. -y will automatically accept all the defaults. So we run this, we should get a package.json. We're going to make an index.js file. And we're going to go ahead and create a main method, which will be an asynchronous method that will have an event parameter. And for now, we're just going to console log what the event parameter holds. AWS Lambda will actually put some information inside of this event parameter for us. And we're simply going to return an empty string. Now, in order for AWS Lambda to actually access this method, we have to use exports.handler equals main. And we're going to go into a previous video tutorial, and we're going to copy a startup script. This will be in the description if you want to copy it. Okay, so now we have this here. If we run this and we return test and we run npm run test, we see it prints out test, so everything is working so far. We're now going to install the AWS SDK using npm install AWS SDK. Now that it's installed, we can import it. AWS equals require, AWS SDK, and then we want to create an S3 object, which we can do through new aws.s3. Keep in mind that this S is capitalized. We're now going to create an upload function, which will be an asynchronous function, and we're going to create a parameters object that's going to hold some information that will be sent to S3. The first thing will be the ACL, which is access control list, and we're going to say public-read. This will give the file access to be read from anyone. We're then going to say the body is going to be hello world. The content type will be text/HTML. The bucket will be worn off keys. Obviously, you'd enter your own bucket name. You can get that by going to your bucket and then looking at whatever name is there. And then the key is going to be the file name, and we're going to say testfile.txt. So now we're going to return a new promise that'll have resolve and reject. And in here, we're going to say s3.putObject, which is how you upload a file. We're going to pass in our parameters, and we get a callback that gives us an error or the results. And so now inside of this callback, we can say if there's an error, we're going to reject with the error. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the results. And so now in our main function here, we want to go ahead and return upload. So if we save this and we run it with npm run test, we get an e tag, which means that everything worked. If we go to our S3 bucket and we refresh, we now see testfile.txt. If we open this in a new tab, we see hello world. So that worked. So that's actually how we can upload a file using the direct content inside of the file. But what if we already have a file? Well, we can import the FS package, and we can change this body to await fs.readFileSync. And what we're going to do here is we're going to create a file name variable. We will call the file toUpload.txt. We're actually going to create that file right now. New file, toUpload.txt. We're going to say testing. We can save and close that. And so we're going to use backticks for a string literal, and we're going to access the file using the file name. Now the key of this is going to be the actual file name on the S3 bucket to keep it consistent. We're just going to use the same variable there. So now if we save this and we run the code again, we go back to our S3 bucket and we refresh. We now see toUpload. If we open that into a new tab, we now see testing, which is the exact contents that we have on our file. So now that we have this working, we're going to actually get this running on a live Lambda function. So because we don't want to deal with having an actual file in the Lambda function, I'm going to show you an example of the first step we did, where we actually have the content or the body of the file to be inside the code here. So we can get rid of the FS import. We can get rid of the file name. This body can become hello world again, and the key here can be file from lambda.txt. So now we want to actually put all of our stuff from our Lambda function into a .zip file. We can open this folder in Windows Explorer. Alternatively, you can just navigate to your folder. And we would want to select all the files inside of our folder. Keep in mind, you do not want to select the folder itself, but rather all the files inside, and you want to send them to a zip file. However, in this exact case, because we only have AWS installed, this comes prepackaged when you're running a live Lambda function. So we don't actually need to include this unless you have a reason to include a specific version of AWS SDK. In this case, we probably will never have that problem with that. So we can simply ignore node modules to speed up the process. Of course, if you had other things installed that are third-party libraries, you will still have to include node modules, otherwise Lambda will not be able to access those. So if we select these files, we can right-click, send to, compress zip folder. We can go over to AWS, and we can open Lambda in another tab. We're then going to create a new function using the create function button. We'll call this warn off keys S3 upload. And we actually need to create some new permissions specifically for this function. So we're going to open IAM, which allows us to edit the permissions. We're going to create a new policy first. The service will be S3. The actions will be all S3 actions. We want this Lambda function to have access to everything just for simplicity. We don't want to have to go through and select specific things. Typically, you won't want to do this in an actual production environment. You want to select only the things you need. We can click on resources, and we can specify that we only want to gain access to the warn off keys bucket and any objects inside of it. Click on add, review the policy. The name can be warn off keys S3 upload, and we're going to create the policy. So now that that's been created, we want to attach this policy to a role that the Lambda function can actually use. So we can create a role using Lambda. We're going to select the permissions. We're going to search for warn off keys. We're going to select the one thing that pops up. We're going to click on tags. We're going to leave these blank. We're going to click on review. We're going to name it warn off keys S3 upload, and we're going to create the role. You can go ahead and close out of this now. And we can select choose or create an execution role. We can use an existing role. Type in warn off keys S3 upload. If yours isn't there, you might want to refresh. And then we can select the role you just created, and then we can click on create function. Now that this is here, we got our function code, which is some very basic stuff. We want to upload our own code though. So we're going to click on actions, upload a zip file. We're going to upload index.zip. We're going to save this, and we see that we have our new code right here. Now we want to go ahead and test this code. And to do that, we can select the test event and then configure test events. We're simply going to name this event test. The parameters that get passed into this event don't matter because they're never used. We'll leave them blank like this. We're going to create the test, and we're going to run the test by clicking on test. So it says it succeeded. If we click on details, we will see the etag object, similar to what we saw locally. If we go to our S3 bucket and we refresh, we now see file from Lambda. If we open this in a new tab, we will see hello world as expected. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.